You got your radio on?
Yeah.
Okay. Radio check.
Radio check.
Okay, gotcha.
Radio check, radio check.
Okay, MT, we gotcha.
I'm clear, nice and clear.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Today, we are at Salt Fork. We're going to be doing a night and day investigation here. Today, I have Tin Man, MT Paranormal Life, with me. We've been in here investigating, gifting, doing everything that we do in other places here. We're gonna see how good it works out for us. Right now I'm headed down to the lake. They're off in two separate areas. Tin Man's up on a ridge. MT's back in the forest. MT, Tin Man, you guys want to say hello?
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Salt Fork. Hello, everybody. It's great to have you here.
All right. So we haven't did no tree knocks, nothing yet. We just gifted, set up an area. I sprayed some pheromone. Now I'm cutting through here to see if I can't get down to the lake, see what we can't find. We did find some tracks that were kind of weird. I'm not gonna say that they were Bigfoot tracks, but they were kind of weird. We couldn't get any toe definition out of them or anything. It's pretty dense in here. And on this trail here, which it looks like it's animal made. I'm seeing a bunch of down sticks, broken sticks, things like that. Tree breaks, tree bends. They could be natural, could not be. Seeing a lot of trash. Look at this. Looks like someone made this place home at one point. That looks fairly new. I think somebody was camping here. Bring up a buoy to sit on. Possibly. So I'm gonna mark this down as all this interaction through here is human. They left trash. Let's see. This was earlier this year, maybe a couple months ago. Okay, so any interaction over here, anything that I'm seeing here, this is all human. I'm gonna mark it off too. Mm-hmm. All human interaction. Which, come on, people. This is a state park. Clean up the mess. All right. With that said, I'm going to work my way out of this area and into another. And that's what I seen. I kind of seen some disturbance, so I followed it in. Looks like animals have been taking this path too. All right. Welcome to Salt Fork. Get back at you. All right. Welcome back. See in this area, got some heavy prints and the disturbance. Pretty quiet out here. And if you see anything, leave it in the comments below. I'm gonna keep on continuing. Yeah. Seeing this trail here. I see a lot of leaves up here, like flipped. That's what I'm looking for. Now, if these were flipped any closer together, I wouldn't mess with it. I would say that's human disturbance, but see how this is ruffled up here and then the next one's ruffled up here. That's what I'm following. Trying to listen for anything that's maybe moving farther away from me. So again, I got the 360 sound hooked up and I have that for background noise. I just heard something popping over here. I have that for background noise. And I'll have it turned up to about 600%. So the leaves rustling under my feet might sound loud, but they're not. Me talking might sound loud, but I'm not. It's not loud at all. It's just so you can hear farther when I stop moving. So this is just the first part of this trip that we have planned for Salt Fork. We wanted to get here before it started snowing. And then be back here when there's snow on the ground. down in there. I'm on a ridge right now, working my way down.
Radio check, how do I sound from here?
Sound good to me.
All right, copy.
Switch hands real quick. Man, these prickers are relentless up in here. These are how prickers will grab you, and I don't want to let go. So periodically, I'll stop and scan while I keep moving. Hut structure. Looks like something getting started. Something big has made it their way through here and didn't care about briars or anything. Could be deer, could not be. This is where it came from up there. Yeah, something stepped on these. Now those flattened. So that's things to look for. It's good things to look for. Definitely tell this is a deer path.
I'm going to do a couple knocks up here.
10-4, I'll let you know if I hear them and how many. You can tell a deer disturbance because you can tell the prints are real close together in the leaves. Heard one. Four on that. What a change, huh?
Yeah, it's a nice one too.
See if anything's watching me. So when I picked my spot to gift, I sprayed scent down, pheromones, from a couple different things for scent that had great scent to it that would possibly drive something's curiosity to come in and smell it. Sorry, I got a pricker in my finger. And we put a tree cam down to watch the area. We did, Mike just let out the first knock. I'll go back up to that area in a little bit and we'll do a couple tree knocks there, a couple whoops to see if we can't call in something. And we'll go from there. And we're gonna set a couple of the spots up tonight. Getting a pricker out of my finger. Just like I suspected, a deer trail. Looks like you can see the path. So what I'll do also with these prickers here, like we always do, we'll take our time, continue to look for any fur, and if there's any, we'll collect it, take it back to our guy. That's what the other guys are doing also. If they see any, they'll collect it.
Ten four.
Oh, did you hear that? I think I heard something whoop right after yours. Did you hear that?
Yes, I did.
I wonder if the camera picked that up. Right after his whoop in the distance. That was strange. Listen for that noise when I said in the distance. I thought I heard something go, whoa. Sound like it came up from that way. Did you hear that? Tell me y'all heard that.
I I heard something, but it's a little bit faint.
Yeah, it was definitely off in the distance.
I got a lot of tracks up here. I don't know where it's from, but it's a lot of tracks.
I found something possible that looks like a nesting area. Look at that. That fork is pretty big. It's around 13,000 acres. I don't know the exact number. I believe it's like 12,200 and a number of acres. Look at this. Whoa. Going down. Wow. That's pretty big. Keep going. Closer. That was strange. Just heard something really strange. Strange.
I'm gonna do a whoop up here.
Copy that. Heard it. Something went. Listen. Something's going.
I just heard something from the north. Almost sounded like a whoop, but a distant one.
I'm north and I hear something going.
Yeah, I'm far up this hillside to the east here, and I feel like I'm moving closer to some things, and I think I zoomed in on something that was watching me.
Something's watching me. Tell me. Something over here. I was hearing it here. Now I'm hearing it here. Got something right here, indentation. Kinda reminds me of a break right through here. Could be old. Before I said I heard a growl, so if you got your headphones on, rewind it. The big spin back here. Okay. That's a big break. Definitely. And then old. Okay. Feels like a good break. Something's watching me. Look at this. Seeds. I wonder if something was collecting seeds. Yeah, I got a copy.
All right, I read you.
We're going to take some of these seeds and gift these. Maybe something can't get out. Mama with the youngster. Something from the forest. I haven't done any tree knocks or roots yet. Some dick's been coming down through here.
Like 100 yards from where I'm at right now, so I'll get back to you as soon as I find out what this is.
10-4, I'm headed due north. I'm finding some interesting things. Look at that. It's all the way out here. Ooh, look at that. There's the heel. get a size on these real quick. I don't have the tripod. We're at 17. That's what we get up by our area. 17.9.
I'm going to do some Knox log here right now.
If that's a print, that's about the same that we get up north in northeast Ohio. Oh yeah, you're quite a ways away from me.
Yeah, I'm not going to stretch a lot further east here, but just a little bit.
Copy that. I just measured what I think was a print, and I'm getting about the same that we get up northeast, 17 by 9. Copy that. If you can, try to get a, if you see any prints, try to measure them out. But it seems like they're all about the same size of what we get up northeast.
All right, copy.
Okay, so I dropped down into this. Could be a creek bed. And cross over to the other side. These are something. Something is forging for. I'm gonna take a couple of these too. Try to get something that's natural for them. You know, so when I go to offer them, it seems like I forge for them. I'm looking for something for them. I'm not just bringing them something. Like I'm part of their tribe by forging for them. Want to kind of hold off on the tree max. Something's like this. Hold off on a tree max. It's old. Till I follow this all the way down to the water. Salt Fork is a beautiful place. I hope in this footage we get some great evidence tonight. And we'll definitely be back when there's snow on the ground. So before we leave, we hope to set up a like a main base area. Drop the rest of what we find gifting wise and what we have gifting wise in that main base area. So when we come back, You know, they'll kind of... Maybe they'll come back and check that area. And when we come back, drop some more there. This is interesting. I'm gonna move it. Oh, that's where your deer slid. Yeah, you can see where the deer slid. It's the pulse pressing in. Well, this was a baby deer, young deer. Maybe not a baby, but running with its mama. Let's see if we can follow it. Because they're going to take the path of least resistance because she's got a young one. There's the water out there. And we're getting close. It's a good sign. Something stepped on this, brushed it. Definitely been back here even. This is what they're after. If I can crack it. Show y'all what they're after. Inside that, they want this. And that is probably packed with a lot of vitamin. Or source of vitamin. Take that. Pace. Yeah. Something's in the back here eating. I got a good choice. Head off this way. I'm committing you this way. I think each spot's gonna get me to the lake. But I can continue on this one. I have not seen no human interaction back here. Nice tree bank.
I made my way all the way up to a clearing, and there is a pretty big sized main trail that seems to go east and west.
10-4, I'm about 500 yards away from the lake, north, on no trail, deer trail. Yeah, this hasn't seen human prints in a good while. Whoa, did my camera just glitch? That's weird. I hear a truck off in the distance. Wow, this is all briar. Definitely used by something coming in. All right, I'm gonna chop my way to the lake. This is all briar. So when I get down there, I'll get you guys back on scene. All right, see you in a minute. All right, welcome back. Worked my way down here. Didn't seem like it was a long way down here, but there's a lot.
I'm recording, and I went to my SLS camera, and I'm picking up a figure of a man in a tree.
Copy that. What else here?
Probably from what I've seen, probably about 100 feet.
This has been used.
It's a full pair.
See what we can find that's been used in this. I'm currently on the beach. Can't Okay, so we got big buck. Big, big, big buck.
I am the exact opposite of a beach right now.
Right now, I'm just looking for any heavy print. Look at that. He's tracking the deer. That is a coyote. That's a big... Yeah, that's a big coyote. And it looks like this was from last night, tracking a, see how they're walking in a circle? They want that baby. They're looking for that baby. Yep. I don't see no large prints that are in the water, but we'll keep on looking and keep on hearing something behind me. Coyote print, deer print. Now, anytime that you're by mud and you see a print, that's not the size of the print. You know, so looks like a pretty big print, huh? But the mud smashes down.
I put the LiDAR on and it's gone. And plus I put a couple other filters on here. So it's gone.
So when it, you know, steps down, the mud spreads out to make the print look bigger. Sinking. This is interesting. Wow. Oh yeah, I'm sinking quick in this stuff. Whatever came through here. Big, looks like a big buck. He got muddy, that's for sure. Muddy. Yeah, so anything that would leave a print like mine, I don't see nothing on the outskirts here. I see some big indentations, but you know, this could be something that was washed out. Can't. I mean, you could say, yeah, seen some big indentations, but you can't put a name on anything. It's just something that you've seen. Could be washed out. Could not be, but definitely something big is using that. All right. Walk down here a little bit on this side, and then we'll get back into the forest. least we could say we covered the beach. Anything like that, I think we all know what that is. That's from geese. Raccoon. Now, the deeper these prints go into the mud like this, this thing was running, and you could tell. This deer was running. It was coming this way, going that way. There's a crane print. Yeah, this deer was really getting it.
Absolutely beautiful.
In the distance. Spot anything watching me. Guess they're probably getting blasted by wind right now. Sorry about that. Go ahead, get back in the forest. Long day.
I'll knock up here, way up here to the east. I'm gonna knock back, just heads up.
See if we hear him. Okay, so I heard the knock come from across the lake, so he's far. We're really all scattered apart. Watch this tree line, I'm hearing something.
Tracks down there, Jack?
It's a negative.
Anybody knock from your direction?
I did no knocks. Haven't done any at all. I'm all the way north. We investigated this a little bit. I don't see no distinctive footprints. I do see big prints, like so. I do see big prints like that. I'm not going to put a label on them. They could be, you know, old, you know. We can tell that's some kind of print. It could be old, they could be new. They could just be washed out, holes. Not sure. So, we'll just leave these. Yeah, whatever you think. Weird. When I bent down and said, whatever you think, if you got headphones on, turn it up and play that back and tell me if you heard a growl. I keep on getting growls down here. But, yeah. Let's see them like that. And then, I mean, if you want to call that a print, let's just say, yeah, you know what? That's a print. Let's just see what we got. I mean, there's a heel to it. That's a big heel. There's a big heel to it, so. Let's look at the length. So. We're getting 17. Okay, getting 17.
He's got another knock up here. I'm gonna knock again.
17 by 8. So, I mean, you could tell right here, you could tell there's a heel. Look how wide that goes. I mean, you could see them. Boop, 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 boop. They continue down. Not like they don't continue down. It's not like, you know, just finding one print and you wonder, well, where's the other prints? I mean, there is a left and a right. But we can't put a name, you know, tag it. We can't say, yep, that's 100% a Bigfoot. What has a 17-inch print by 8?
Nothing heard, MC.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't hear it either.
All right, copy.
But we could say, like I just said, we could say, you know, what has a big 17-foot print, you know, by 8-9 inches wide? I mean, we all know what does, but I can't say definitely that that's what it is. I won't do that. We all know that. We don't do that here. We never use that word. We'll leave it up to you all. We just show the evidence, but we'll go from there. I mean, I will let the guys know that, yeah, I've seen some prints, but nothing that we could call 100% Bigfoot Grassman here at the Salt Fork. Beautiful Salt Fork Park Forest. All right, I'm going to get back in here. Probably going to collect a little bit more of those seeds and get ready to do some tree knocks and get ready to go dark. It is, well, it's 4, morning, afternoon. So we've been here quite a few hours. We got some good footage for y'all. We did bring every piece of equipment that we own. It's here with us. And if you made it this far, please hit that like button. And if you haven't subscribed, we keep going all year long. All right, y'all. I'll get back at you. Oh, this ain't over yet. Believe that. Man, I gotta find my way back through this stuff. All right. See you in a few. All right, welcome back. I got in the forest. Got down that ravine. Starting to see some weird breaks and bends. I collect a couple more seeds so I can make a secondary. I'm hearing knocking. Anyone knocking? Far apart. Let's continue. So what I'll do with this, again, I've got enough to make two more gifting spots. I'll add some of the items that we brung. Throw a couple glow sticks on it, spray some pheromone nearby. And do things our way while we're out here. What works for us. Everybody's got different ways of doing things. That worked for them perfectly, and we got ours that worked for us perfectly. There's some deer tracks in here. There's all kinds of tracks in here. Deer tracks. One thing I'm surprised I haven't seen, any bear. You would think, being such a big area, living area, that you would start seeing bear, bear prints down by the water, signs of bear. I walked part of that. Just to see a little bit more. And there was no sign. What? I turned 360. Lake's down there. I don't know if you can. That's the lake. That's where it came from. I heard a strange knock. And a weird...
Hey, I just want to note, when I'm making my way back down this trail towards you, I'm getting a really high energy field spike and the radiation field spike. I've never had a spike before where it alerted like this, so something strange is going on here.
Yeah, I'm telling you, this area in here is it's high electric. I feel staticky. I feel like when I'm walking back up this ridge, I feel like nervousness, you know what I'm saying? Like that weird just feeling that you get. Like when you're around a lot of electric. Well, you might want to get out of that area.
Yeah, I'm working my way down and monitoring it because it seems like it's moving with me.
Oh, wow. Maybe something's following you, something's cloaked. Still on the
phone.
Copy that. Still on the fence about the cloaking, but coming around. Coming around to it. We're finding evidence of it. That could be cloaking. Gotta try to make it through this stuff here.
Necrometer, and the first thing it came across, it says, "I'm watching you," and now nothing. That's the only thing it said.
Wow, that's strange.
Hear a thump or a bang. I'm gonna throw this rock here real quick, just so you guys know.
Whoa. Car in the distance. A plane. I haven't did any knocks yet. Get back up this ridge and I will get back at you.
This, but there's something over here making a knocking sound rapidly and it's soft. It's definitely not a woodpecker.
Yeah, I've been hearing it. Trying to catch it. I think it's following me. Y'all hear that knock about 2 minutes ago? Alright, I'm gonna do a couple knocks after yours, spread them apart. Going higher up in elevation. What the? I just heard. Never mind. I don't know what I heard. That was strange. I heard something. I don't know if the camera caught it. But I'm not going to sit here. Got a copy on you.
You know where I first split off and went straight to the east and up the hillside? I should be coming out to that intersection on the flat ground.
10-4, I'm hearing some weird little knock taps. Hearing some things back here. Strange. All right, I'm going to go recover MT. I was just trying to see if you guys would hear those knocks.
Today is Saturday, November 11th, 2023. It's Veterans Day. Thank you to all our veterans out there. We're so proud of you all, both past and present, men and women of the armed services. I've got 816 feet, about 200 feet below where we live. Okay, I'm gonna climb to the top of this ridge. I do have a lot of trees down here in this area. We're down here at Salt Fork. Buddy, it's great to have you here. Oh boy, look at this. shrub. Not a bad sized deer. Of course, there's a smaller one too. So we're out here in Salt Fork State Park, and plenty of deer, and we're out here with some, we have bear in this area too, but I'm just hoping they're not too active. Got my bear spray with me. Climbing this hill. Plan on walking this ridge. This should be probably about 1,000 feet. So, this is what I've got. Kimbolton, Ohio. It says 870 feet. That's what I'm looking at right here. And that's actually north. Gloves back on. I don't know if that's a rub, but it might have been. Looks like there's a pretty good sized boy. Let me go on the other side here. Pretty good sized boy got into that one. That's for sure. was going to run, walk this ridge. But apparently, it keeps going up.
Check. How do I sound from here?
Sound good to me.
All right, copy. I'm going to do a couple knocks up here.
10-4, I'll let you know if I hear them and how many. Heard one.
Okay, I made
made two.
Yeah, this is some beautiful country. I think I'm going to give a whoop.
Copy.
Whoop!
I think I heard something whoop right after yours. Did you hear that?
Yes, I did. I heard something, but it was a little bit faint.
Yeah, it was definitely off in the distance.
I got a lot of tracks up here. I don't know what it's from, but it's a lot of tracks.
I found something possibly that looks like a nesting area.
I just heard something from the north. Almost sounded like a whoop, but a distant one.
I'm north and I hear something going, oh, oh.
Yeah, I'm far up the hillside to the east here, and I feel like I'm moving closer to some things, and I think I zoomed in on something that was watching me.
I see a lot of tree bends.
check, see if you can still hear me.
Yeah, I got a copy.
Okay, I see a few interesting things. I'm gonna go explore here. If I'm out of radio range, I'll get back to you guys in a little bit.
Four.
All right, copy that. Maybe as you're moving periodically, just do a radio check to see if it's starting to fade out or not.
Okay, it looks like 100 yards from where I'm at right now, so I'll get back to you as soon as I find out what this is.
10-4, I'm headed due north. I'm finding some interesting things.
Yeah, way up here to I'm going to do 2 knocks while I'm here right now. I'm not going to stretch a lot further east here, but just a little bit.
Copy that. Just measured what I think was a print, and I'm getting about the same that we get up northeast, 17 by 9. Get up northeast.
Alright, welcome back. So, we got through today. Seen some crazy stuff. Now we're here at night. We got a little base camp started. Tin Man, say hello.
Hello, everybody.
Didn't get to say hi last time.
Yeah. Glad to be here.
MT.
What's up? How's it going?
Both of these guys were recording through the day. You'll see. Well, Tin Man's going to give me his, and I'll put his footage up.
Yeah. I'm gonna get mine up pretty quick. Hopefully for my next video drop, I want to get this one in there because it's been great so far.
Oh yeah, heck of a day. So can you tell us a little bit what you've seen, MT, through the day, so these guys and girls got an idea?
Well, I went towards the east high ground.
You know what? Let me kill this light so it's not killing you.
And I captured some audio of what sounded to be knockbacks from when I was knocking. Most interestingly, though, I captured a lot of energy, including high electric field and radiation energy and magnetic field. All three, I kept getting just spike waves. And I've never captured, any... all three spikes in all three ranges before. The radiation energy was kind of shocking, but I'm not sure if we can explain why that is.
Yeah.
But that was really strange, and it seemed like I was communicating possibly with something, maybe a spirit, and it was interacting with my device when I asked it to. So there were some interesting things, sounds, that, all that stuff. I can't wait to get that out so everybody can see that. Oh, the knockings were really, I think I mentioned that before, but there were some really interesting knocks, and you probably heard the same ones I did.
Yeah.
Light tapping, rapid tapping.
Yep, I did. Tin Man.
Yeah, I took the North Ridge from where we were parked. Climbed up the hill. It was like a 200-foot climb. The elevation was like 760. By the time I finished the climb, it was pretty close to 1,000 feet. Got up to the top of the ridge, saw a lot of deer tracks.
deer rubs, you know, the scrapes on the trees. Actually, some pretty big deer. And then I got the Ghost Tube SLS cam out and was scanning the horizon, and I saw one of the stick figures, you know, if you're familiar with that. I saw a stick figure of a man about 100 feet up a tree. And I was following that. He would go left, he would go right. And then I got kind of tired of it, actually. But then I shut her down, and then we had to meet back at the car, so I went back down the hill. So it's pretty good.
So that's pretty good. They say that Bigfoot cloaks, so that's what you might have got.
Yeah, it was full-figured up in a tree about 100 feet.
Awesome. Can't wait to...
Yeah, there was no question about it.
Can't wait to see that. All right. All right, tonight, so we set up a little base camp. So we got an area that we chose. We got a good echo off this lake here doing calls. So we started off by doing some knocks. The knocks echoed out and did some calls. We set up some glow sticks up there, up here. We'll take a walk over there in a minute, but there's some glow sticks back there, and we sprayed everything down with pheromones. Each glow stick has pheromones on it. We gifted some food, glow sticks, some candy. We did some other things that you can ask us when we do a Q&A, but yeah, that's like pheromone city up there. So if there's something out there, we're hoping that will attract it close. But here, listen to this echo. Whoop! So we're hoping that it brings something towards us from that side. Let's take a walk over here and show some glow sticks. Just one of many that we got up. Got some farther, got some closer. Right here, the orange glow sticks, if you see them, they indicate a gifting area. So on that tree, there's scent of lemon and lime. See if that brings them out. Just a lot of different tactics here at Salt Fork that we're using throughout the whole day. See if we can bring this thing out and get it on film for you. All right, with that said, we'll get back at you. The night hunt. All right, welcome back. Headed uphill. careful climbing this hill. I'm gonna get to the top of this hill and I'll get back to you. All right, welcome back. Okay, so I left the main camera up at home base. So I kind of went old school. I have a headlamp and a flashlight. And I'm going to go up this ridge.
We're going to go up in there, but boy, it's just nothing but thickets.
Hey, I don't know if you heard that. I'm standing over here by the water and something huge just went in the water.
10-4, I heard that all the way over here. Is no joke.
Right where I'm standing, I'm almost level with the water.
This is about a 400 foot ridge. Whoa.
Jack, there's another one that just hit the water over here.
Something's throwing rocks into the water. I heard it. I'm coming. Where are you? I'm hearing something move up on this ridge. Another one. I'm gonna do a whistle.
Yeah, that was me.
And 3, 2, 1.
And I'm guessing that was you, right?
Yeah, copy that. I said I was gonna do a whistle. Back. I'm gonna go high and see if I can see down low, see past you.
I'm gonna knock on this tree over here.
Ten four.
Copy that.
10-4. I'm hearing some kind of animal or something in the distance. You guys hearing that?
Yeah, I'm hearing it too.
I'm gonna do some whoops.
Up in the air, oh, probably about 3 feet, and it looks like a headstone of some sort.
And 3, 2, 1, whoop! There. Straight ahead. I got something straight ahead.
Move up and flank on your right.
This is what I'm going to do. This is what I was looking for. I'll get right back at you. I'm going to set some trap cams. And go back to the original style on tripod. Get right back at you. All right. We're down to a couple lights. I'm gonna head up to where I heard this thing. thing. Ridge. I'm gonna do a whoop. Whoop! Something was throwing rocks at these guys. I think they were coming from up here because set you all down. I'm gonna go up here and do a tree knock. If I can get this to stay straight.
Off 3 tree knocks. stump get thrown again? I'm gonna blast off two more tree knocks.
I'm alright over here right now. Looking around, I'm trying to see where you are.
There's something up in front of me. There's something back here. Guys, I got something up here in front of me.
Alright, I'm heading up to the water up towards you.
They're down there. I'm like walking through this dense stuff. There's an X in the tree. Could be natural. Could not be. I didn't even see it. Look at these veins, man. Wow. These ravines are no joke. These ravines are no joke. Can we get back over there up and around, it looks like.
Look at that.
Yeah, the X, I didn't even notice it until I turned around. I thought I heard something behind me. And bam, there it was.
I get my meter out and go over and see if...
See if it sparks anything. Over here. Or right here. I'm not sure why there's a big hole in the ground. That's strange. I'm going to try climbing this and going over to that. I don't know what that is. All right. Yeah. There, I just popped out of my way. Whoa. This is some slippery stuff. Yeah, we don't want to go down there. Set you down right here. What is this? This. Wow. There's not a good spot to set you down in. MT, come check this out. We gotta get back up in there. Whoa, bro. Holy.
This side too, I see it.
Wow.
All the way up, tore up.
It is tore up. Something's tearing the hell out of this thing. look at you. Yeah. You wanted to stay hidden. MT said that this is definitely the place. Looks like something's been through here, just busting this stuff up. See that? Yeah. This is how you get. This is how you get into an area to search for cryptids.
It's going pretty good. I'm gonna come up with you guys a little bit. There's a lot of activity down in that lake.
Whoa. And four, you want us to wait for you right here?
No, go ahead and do what you're doing. I'm just going to look around here.
All right. We found a strange area. Yeah, it's strange. Keep going, watch your step. Yeah, I don't think anybody does it like this. Here at Salt Fork at night.
There's something weird going on, but I don't feel like anything's threatening.
Yeah, I don't feel like anything's threatening us. I think it just is like... Who are these strange people coming into my domain? And they keep on coming farther in. I'm going to do a whoop. And 3, 2, 1. Whoop! Something, man. Look at this. Something is just tearing this up. Wow, it's really thick up through here. We gotta go. We gotta go in. Ten four, let her go. I'll do a whoop. Whoop!
Okay, I'll do another.
Okay, and then I'll do another whoop. Whoop! Okay. I'm gonna cut up here, higher. MT, I think I found something. Holy. Let's see. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy, if this is what I think it is. Look at this. If you're gonna be something, you're gonna be right in here. Something moves stuff here. Wow.
Well, that raised something. Yeah, I heard it. I heard the noise up in the trees.
Got an X right in front of me. Yeah, they're strange. That's for sure. Be natural? Could not be. You know what I'm not seeing? That we haven't caught in a while? Eyeshine. What's that? Getting a spike?
I had some more electric and radiation spikes.
Yeah, look at that. How many miles do you think we're in here? We are in here. Hear that?
Coming from towards me. I heard something like a hoot or a whoop or something come from my left. It's distant. There it is again.
There it is again. Want to go dark up here? You know what's strange? Huh. Either that's a dog out here in the forest. That's definitely not a coyote.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like, a dog.
Yeah. Hey man, let me know if that dog gets any closer. Set y'all down for a second.
The dog seems to be pretty far away, but I hear a lot of, I don't know, are you guys moving around quite a bit?
We're not even moving around, we're standing still. No, I guess that dog sounds close to us because we're so high up.
Gotta sit down on a rock and see what my camera can find.
You got another tree knock in you?
Yeah. I might have one or two.
Then we'll have to get you a new tree knocker.
Too, man. I really gave this thing a run. Alright.
A lot of stuff up from in the trees, top of the trees.
What do you want to do? You want to do just some like series of knocking back and forth type of deal?
Yeah, I can do that with you. Let me put this light away and grab my...
Hey, man, you're going to start hearing some knocking coming from us up here. Okay, go ahead.
Let's see.
Hold on, let me find a tree. Let me find a good tree. Nope. I'm gonna go higher. All right, I got one.
All right, I'll start off with something.
All right. Airplane. Okay. Just got something from this way. Alright, I'm going to use a different tree. Man, this is like a side of a mountain, bro. This just keeps going up and up and up. Alright, you ready? Alright. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1. Do a whoop. In 3, 2, 1. Whoop!
Whoop!
One knock. Going to do another whoop. 3, 2, 1. Whoop!
Whoop!
My light keeps on popping out and off. Set y'all down for a second. Maybe. Yeah, we can do that. Yep, I'm going to leave you right here for a second. We're going to see if we can't spark something off. We're going to do a knock, 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 knock. And then knock, knock. All right, you ready? 3, 2, 1. Hear some.
It's like gibberish.
Tin Man, you talking?
No, it's not me.
I usually don't say that. That sounds like gibberish.
Yeah, that's 100% gibberish. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Tree knocker broke. All right, one tree knocker down. Yeah, those were good tree knockers. We lost one tree knocker. Man, you can hear a lot of stuff up here. There's some crazy stuff going on, but I just caught some eye shine up here. Oh, some more eye shine straight ahead. Straight ahead. This area right here is dense. Definitely, if you were a Bigfoot grass man, you wanted to get lost in here, this would be the area. All right, y'all. From here, check out this night vision footage. I'll throw some music behind it so you're just not bored watching it. Let's see what we can't find. Thank you.
Thank you.
Some good footage. covered it pretty good in this area. And now we're going to work our way into another area. Heard some movement through here. Definitely strange. Place is strange. Ain't no doubt about that. Alright, we're gonna get into another area and I'll get back at you. Up this ridge. Ooh, feel the burn. Feel the burn. Amazing, we're getting rocks thrown at us. Wouldn't think that would come from the Salt Fork area, but it did, and we got it on video. You heard it. We're hitting the water. So dense in here, isn't it? Do a tree knock? Yeah. All right. I'll do a whoop.
Whoop.
And three.
Whoop.
Two. One. Whoop! All right, I'll do a whoop afterwards. Whoop! This top of this ridge. We'll get back to you. We got lights dying. Yeah, get back to you.
Hi guys and girls, Jack the cameraman here. Salt Fork.
Number one.
No
doubt.
Gun.
D-U-N.
What'd you think about it tonight, gentlemen? What do you think about it, Tim?
Oh, I'm coming back. I love this. Beautiful spot.
I think we did a lot. We did a lot on camera. We did a lot off camera. Tree knocks. Did so many tree knocks. His tree knocker broke.
It's all gone.
It is now a butter churning stick.
Yep.
Yes. We did so many calls.
Voices wore out.
Voices. I'm going to eat a pack of Halls when I get home. It is 29 degrees.
Yep.
I think that we hit this place our style. And I hope we got a lot of stuff on video for y'all.
Yeah. I think we had some interaction for sure. Heard voices, yeah. Knocks, some weird readings going on here.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on here, but there is something happening.
Oh yeah, definitely. And the radiation.
The lake.
Yeah.
No question about that.
The rocks, that's crazy.
Yeah, something throwing rocks at us.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure we all captured that on our audio. I captured one with my camera. I don't know how well it came out, but because the lake was dark, but I was filming that way and heard it land, saw the waves, saw where it hit.
Yeah, got a couple whistles. Something took some of the gifting that we put down. I think it was a good night.
Oh yeah.
I think we
first good visit.
Hit it our style.
Yeah. Fantastic.
And hopefully next time we come, Trapper's with us.
Yeah, we gotta get Trapper.
Yeah, he's gotta get out of here, all Trapper. You missed it. But hey, I hope Ohio State won. And you had fun. That said, wait. With that said, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button.
Share it.
We did it our way.
Hey, and you're almost at 7,000 now, right?
Almost, yeah.
Make sure this channel gets the 7,000 and MT gets his share too. He does some fantastic stuff.
Yeah, to get to MT's page, you can go to the homepage. Scroll all the way to the bottom, to the featured section. I feature a bunch of channels there. Those are all the channels I like, and MT is one of them. Click on his channel, hit that subscribe button, watch his stuff, hit that like button, thumbs up, hit that notification bell. I'll try to get Tin Man here a page.
No, not me.
He says no.
Start thinking of a name for it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Tin Man Chronicles. But I will add Tin Man stuff from tonight at Salt Fork into this video here. And I hope y'all liked it.
Had a great time.
Yep.
Just gonna have good film. Yep. See good videos from here.
Yep, absolutely. And you can catch MT's on his page. Oh, you don't want to miss, because we are all separated. We don't know what we did. So I'll watch yours, you watch mine, you watch mine, I'll watch yours, you watch his, he'll watch his, you guys watch all of ours.
That's how YouTube works.
Yep.
That's the way to make it work.
Yep. So, we do this all year round. We don't stop because there's snow. We definitely want to get back here when it's snowing so we can follow footprints and hopefully get this thing on film. Again, if you've seen anything, leave it in the comment section below. That said, I'm Jack the Cameraman.
I'm Tin Man.
Mike, MT Paranormal Life.
Hit that like button and subscribe. Salt Fork, one down.
We'll be back.
Bye.